1779. They had signed their declaration, their death warrants on the Declaration of Independence, proclaiming liberty throughout the land and declaring war on Great Britain. The British were pressing hard to keep the rising American colonists from coming up. We knew that liberty was worth fighting for, and thus we gave our lives for it. But we were no soldiers, sailors. We were fishermen, farmers, traders, hunters, politicians, and we were at war with the greatest military power on Earth. Great Britain. However, we were not deterred by the odds, though we were vastly outnumbered, outgunned, outmanned, in every way, all the time. We were sick of it. The British were strong, but they did not realize that the God of the universe fought for us, and they were no match for the burning passion inside the hearts and minds of every American soldier. Not so much the size of the dog in the fight as the size of the fight in the dog. And we had the fight. In that case, I guess you could say that the British had their work cut out for them because they were up against the fledgling American colonies who were willing to die for their liberty. And as Patrick Henry once declared, "Give me liberty or give me death," it became our motto as he burned that into our hearts and minds. And we roared in defiance as we brought our fight to the British. Because of God before us, Great Britain could not stand against us. Now, the Continental Army had no navy. And we were constantly looking for experienced sailors to face the 50-gun British warships. A ridiculous notion. Battleships versus merchant ships and fishing boats? Everyone laughed. And the Brits laughed harder when they saw us coming to attack them. One cannon shot would obliterate our entire vessel. But God usually takes his stand with those who have the odds stacked against them. Now, God provided us with a man by the name of John Paul Jones, Captain John Paul Jones, and hardly any of us liked him. Born in Scotland, he was contentious, headstrong, and downright stubborn. He was even accused of killing a mutineer at sea off the coast of Tobago. What? You could see the eccentricities in his eyes. He always had a bad attitude. And Lord help those who were assigned to his ship. And blast it. If somebody did not make that coffee, it was going to be a very, very bad day. But the British, he had been sailing since he was 12 years old, and this is exactly what the Continental Navy was looking for. He was always looking for a fight in many more ways than just one. This was the man that the Lord provided the Continental Navy to face the 50-gun British warships. The things we disliked about him, however, were indeed of terrible, terrible good use when you put him in a fight. I remember those days. So Captain John Paul Jones, whatever we had at our disposal, was given a merchant ship. There you are. Barely seaworthy, and in no condition to fight. It's better than our rowboats, I suppose. But he took this old relic of a ship and had it rebuilt to be a modern fighting ship. We put 20, no big deal, versus 50 cannons, British always had, 20 of our best cannons, and loaded up as soon as possible. We had to cut out our own holes for our own cannons, for Pete's sake. You should have seen the petty looking thing. But we set sail. Loaded up and set sail with our eyes searching for British warship, looking for a fight. I mean, how crazy is that? Looking for a fight that evening. We went about our routines as the sun set on the horizon. The full moon quickly took its place in the sky. And just when we began to get tired of going about our routines, envisioning a fight that was to come, Captain Jones pulled out his telescope. looking through that telescope. We all stopped and turned our eyes on our captain. And there she was. His prize trophy, the British warship Serapis. All hands on deck! He shouted. We scrambled about, bringing down the sails, eagerly hoping to gain speed. Pursue! He shouted. It was a glorious endeavor. Tonight, gentlemen, we are the fastest ship in the Atlantic Ocean. Chase them down. Glorious endeavor, I tell you. Preparing for battle, Captain Jones went about shouting orders and lending his ferocious energy to his men. His passion was contagious. Our cause was just. Tonight, the Serapis was at the mercy of Captain John Paul Jones and the patriotism that flowed through the veins of every man on board. And then he gave one of his speeches. He always had something to say. Tonight, gentlemen, we are showing the British Navy yet another capable fighting ship of the Continental Navy. Let's give them a good first impression. We were flying across the water at a miraculous speed. God must have heard our prayers, eager itself to have a fight. When we were about 200 yards out, the British did not seem to be taking flight. On the contrary, they were curious as to who might have the guts, or the guns for that matter, to pursue them. But when we were about 200 yards out, the British opened fire on us. Cannons boomed as we heard them tear through the air towards us. We braced ourselves for impact, waiting for cannon shots to come splintering through our vessel at any moment. Finally, a moment of return fire had come. Cannons! He shouted. Ready! Open! Fire! Cannons went blowing up, side to side. Reload! He shouted. Open! Fire! The battle between the Bonhomme Richard, our ship, and the Serapis began. Reload! He shouted again. Open! Fire! The sound of our cannons going off lent confidence to the entire crew and roused the fight that was inside us. We felt the ocean spray upon our faces as enemy shot flew closer, splashing into the sea. Reloaded our cannons, unloading our fury, firing back upon the enemy. Reload! He shouted again and again. Open fire! Suddenly, just as we expected, a cannon shot tore through our vessel and killed multiple men. Captain Jones didn't flinch. He ordered the medics to jump to and take the wounded men below. He even hauled wounded man himself and carried him below deck. We then, another cursed hole tore through our ship. Captain Jones, came back up. Turn the ship towards the Serapis! Go straight for her, he said. If we're going to sink, they're going to sink with us. We turned the ship around, and the Lord granted us strong winds as we flew toward her at an uncanny speed. 100 yards, 100 yards to go, closing the gap. Enemy shots boomed, looming in deadly proximity, firing towards us. We braced ourselves for impact, the men grabbed rifles, beginning a volley of shots, spraying the side of the enemy ship with bullets. God, Providence preserving our ship through that pressure. Cannons tore through our sails. We ducked as they did so, 50 yards to go. We prayed in sweat and blood, pleading to God to give us our enemy and to spare our lives. We then received two more holes as the brakes began to zero in on us. Our ship is being obliterated! Cannon shots tore through our vessel as we received the heavy bombardment. Fire broke out on the floor, and men were dying. Captain Jones finally brought the our ship right up side by side to the British officers, and they fired on us at point blank range. Captain Jones boarded the hooks. Bring up the hooks, boys! We hauled up the hooks, hurling them over to the Serapis, and pulled the ship together, tying them side by side. The gun crew mostly dead, fire raging on board, when the Brits called out for Captain Jones to surrender. The Captain Jones loaded a cannon himself and shot back in defiance with his famous line, "I have not yet begun to fight!" He punctuated his statement, firing that cannon and destroying the British mainmast. Charge! We drew our swords and charged over to the Serapis, heavily engaged in hand-to-hand combat. We brought a ferocious onslaught to the enemy as we demonstrated our intent. The rule of Great Britain was not an option. We were not going to be slaves. We were going to fight and die as free men. Liberty or death. Our ship sunk immediately afterwards. So what could we do? We returned to port in our captured, crippled British warship to our astonished fellow patriots. Can you imagine the American colonists coming back on a British warship? Cheers! We roused the message of liberty, and it spread like fire across all the land to all the colonies, and then on to the entire world. There's God before us. No one could be against us. We knew this land is worth dying for, and so we gave our lives for it. We fought and died for the land that has sent the gospel of Jesus Christ to the farthest corners of the earth. This flag is stained with our blood. Its white stripes display the glory of sacrifice. Will you let the enemy take this freedom from you and destroy all you love? Will you bow with chains around your necks? Never surrender! We have not yet begun to fight! Thank you.